Knuckle cracking. It's a habit that reverberates through schools and offices across the world. Whether you're stretching out your fingers after a long session of typing, or stretching out the time until the end of the day, those distinctive pops from the knuckles can be a source of relaxation or disgust for many. But when we hear a cracking sound in nature, it's usually not good. Like the snapping of a twig, or the cracking of electricity. Could it be the sign of something darker, lurking beneath the surface? And more importantly, how did cracking one particular joint lead to a young paramedic finding herself paralyzed? This episode deals with medical matters and knuckle cracking. We're not doctors. If you have a question about the potential negative side effects of a habit, we recommend that you talk to a licensed physician. Viewer discretion is advised if you find the sound or sight of joints cracking to be distasteful. With that out of the way, let's get into it.
You know, my mom used to tell me that cracking my knuckles would make my hands weak.
Really? I always heard that it gave you arthritis.
Yeah, right. That's dumb.
Ugh, gross.
What? Am I not allowed to stretch now?
Well, stretch out somewhere else.
Yeah, whatever.
Of course, some people like to limber up their fingers after a long period of repetitive work, or to stretch out their hands, or just to hear that ever so satisfying cracking sound. But that all leads to a couple of big questions. What exactly causes the distinctive cracking noise? Is it just a harmless noise? It's likely that you've also heard that habitual knuckle crackers are more likely to suffer from arthritis than those of us who find other ways to pass the time, like playing with fidget cubes, twirling around a pencil, or booping a bobblehead.
Let's get into it.
Or burning tweets.
What? No, that's not a thing.
Yeah, says you.
You're gonna set the house on fire. Again.
Lightning never strikes twice. Or thrice?
This particular story about arthritis is so widespread that Harvard's medical school has written articles detailing the claims with research into the matter. And what do they find? Well, to understand what makes our knuckles crack, we first need to understand a little bit about joints. Joints that are crackable are generally diarthrodial joints, namely, a freely movable joint where the parts that meet are coated in a layer of cartilage. The cartilage surfaces are contained by what is known as a capsule, inside which is a cavity filled with fluids that allows for the joint's freedom of movement. The fluid, also known as synovial fluid, lubricates our joints. When you stretch your fingers out, you stretch the capsule. However, the length of the capsule between bones can stretch is limited by the density of the synovial fluid. So when you forcefully stretch it, gases bubble out of the fluid. And in the words of Dr. Robert Clapper, orthopedic surgeon and co-director of the Joint Replacement Program, the noise of cracking or popping in our joints is actually nitrogen bubbles bursting in our synovial fluid. Or to quote Mayo Clinic orthopedic surgeon Dr. Sanj Kakkar, you're breaking those bubbles up, just like bubble wrap. Now, I know what you might be asking. What is arthritis?
The question had occurred, yes.
Well, to borrow a description from the Mayo Clinic, arthritis is the swelling and tenderness of one or more of your joints. The main symptoms of arthritis are joint pain and stiffness, which typically worsen with age. There are two primary kinds of arthritis: osteoarthritis, which causes the cartilage on your bones to break down, and rheumatoid, a disease which causes your immune system to attack your joints.
Ugh, stupid immune system!
But can cracking your knuckles really cause arthritis?
Well, thankfully for all the knuckle crackers out there, no. To further quote Dr. Clapper, cracking your knuckles does no harm at all to our joints. It does not lead to arthritis. And this is backed up by the Mayo Clinic, who stated that habitual knuckle crackers have been shown to have the same grip strength and range of motion as those who leave their knuckles alone. Though habitual knuckle crackers may develop thicker layers of cartilage than others. To prove that point, one doctor went, a little further than most of us would consider reasonable. Dr. Donald L. Unger of Thousand Oaks, California, got tired of his mother and other annoying grown-ups telling him cracking his knuckles would cause him to develop arthritis when he was a kid. So he embarked on a 50-year-long quest to prove her wrong.
Ah yes, my favorite kind of science. The kind that's motivated by spite.
The greatest motivator.
For half a century, Dr. Unger cracked the knuckles on one hand while leaving his other hand alone to test the effects of knuckle cracking.
Oh wow, and his results?
He found no differences between his hands. Of course, it is important to note that he didn't carry out his experiment in a clinical setting, so there is room for error. But then again, it's nearly impossible to do a study spanning 50 years in a clinical setting. For his troubles, Dr. Unger got an Ig Nobel Prize for medicine. Upon accepting his prize, he said, "Mother, I know you can hear me. Mother, you were wrong. And now that I have your attention, can I stop eating my broccoli, please?"
Wow. Truly a speech for the ages. Looks like you don't get the last word this time, Mom.
But while the cracking noises in your knuckles usually aren't a matter of concern, sometimes they can be a sign of underlying problems. Just like how waves we usually pass off as nothing can be a sign of a deeper, darker secret, lurking deep in the dark corners of the ocean. Your attempts to crack your knuckles shouldn't cause pain. If everything's fine and dandy, it should just be gas bubbles popping, not shots of pain or swelling skin. Should you feel any discomfort, it may be the signs of a bigger issue beneath the surface. Pain, swelling, or limited motion are signs that the joint has damage, possibly from arthritis, trauma, or gout, according to Dr. Clapper.
So there's no harm in cracking your knuckles then?
Well, I never said that. In fact, vigorous knuckle crackers may find their method of cracking knuckles more of a danger than the act itself. Too much pressure in the process can dislocate your fingers, or injure the tendons in your hands, according to the Harvard Medical School.
That's why I like to take it nice and easy.
Ew.
And there's the potential for psychological harm too, in case that anyone around you really hates the sound. Of course, cracking other parts of your body can have much more severe impacts. March 4th, 2019. 23-year-old paramedic Natalie Kunicki was spending time with a friend at her home, watching television in bed. Stretching out her neck, she heard a loud crack. My friend asked, "Was that your neck?" "But all my joints crack quite a bit, so I didn't think anything of it. I just laughed," she said to the Sun. Since there wasn't any pain, Kunicki passed it off as just a particularly loud crack and settled in for a nap. 15 minutes later, she lost feeling in the left side of her body. Kunicki learned this when she tried to go to the bathroom, only to fall to the floor when her leg wouldn't respond. Rushed to the University College Hospital London in the wee hours of the morning, then transferred to the National Hospital for Neurology and Neurosurgery, doctors discovered that Kunicki's neck crack had unintended side effects. The crack had ruptured her vertebral artery and had caused a stroke. Thankfully for her, doctors were able to repair the artery with a stent and said that the blood clot would dissolve over time. Unfortunately for Kunicki, she remained paralyzed for weeks after the incident, and it took around a month of physical therapy for her to regain her movement. And while Kunicki at first didn't want to call emergency services, it's a good thing she did. Untreated strokes can have serious, deadly consequences. Every minute, more of your brain cells are dying, so don't ever discount a stroke just because someone is young. While her doctors couldn't give an exact time frame on a full recovery, Kunicki was hoping to be back to light duties in 6 to 12 months. Dr. Robert Glatter, an emergency physician from Lenox Hill Hospital in New York City, advises against aggressive manipulation or cracking of the neck. In his words, "There is really no safe way to crack your neck. Simply put, it's best to avoid doing it in the first place, to avoid any potential complications." Of course, that doesn't really help in this context, given that Kunicki wasn't trying to crack her neck.
Yeah, so how do you properly stretch your neck?
One of our script goblins learned in karate classes to tuck their chin down to their chest and roll their head back and forth, but go no further than their shoulders. WebMD also has a few suggestions, like rolling your shoulders in a circle forward 6 times, then backwards 6 times. Or starting from a neutral position with your head and back straight. Slowly turn your head to the right until you feel a stretch in your neck. Then hold for 15 to 30 seconds. Then slowly turn your head back to the center and repeat on your left side. At the end of the day, cracking your knuckles is more or less harmless, and you shouldn't worry about it if it helps you get through your day.
So long as you don't get too vigorous and dislocate your fingers.
And just make sure you play it safe when stretching out the rest of your body. Lest you wind up with a real pain in the neck.
Really? Well.
No? Not landing? Oh, how about crack to square one? Get crack on your feet. Oh!
Bro!
Sorry. Guess it's crack to the drawing board for now.
And that's my cue to leave.
Yay, science! Demons, demons, demons! Stop hitting me!